I get asked this question a lot on my stream actually, like, what solo mids are you afraid of, and like, which AP mids scare you from other teams, and who do you consider the best and stuff? And I usually respond to the question like pretty much the same way, like, all AP mids have their own kind of style, and not, like, the styles aren't necessarily like hard, and I'm not necessarily scared of any of their styles. For instance, I know the US teams the best because I don't really play against European teams or European mids. And so I understand that players like Jackie on champions like Ryze will look to trade very early, like levels 1, levels 2, levels 3. He wants to be very aggressive early and trade like a harass and like an auto attack and try to come up on top by being aggressive. Whereas players like Gigi and maybe players like me like to play a little bit more passive, farm through the lane, not take too many risks. And then there's players like Reginald who, there's a misconception about Reginald. Like, people say that Reginald's too aggressive or like very, very aggressive. And that's true. Reginald is very aggressive, but the way that he's aggressive is not what people think. Reginald plays the same whether or not the jungler is nearby or not. And that kind of mind game is how he gets ahead in lane. It helps that he runs 9 defense on every solo mid he plays. But that's a real big thing that helps him get ahead. So if he goes in for a risky harass, and he might not even come out on top if you harass back. But you sometimes don't know, because if you harass back and the jungler is nearby, you're going to die. Or you're going to be forced to use summoners. And that's how Reginald gets ahead in lane. It's actually pretty interesting. It's very specific to Reginald. But like, I'm not too scared of that kind of style either. I'm not scared of the passive style that GG has, or like Reginald's more aggressive style through like his kind of small mind games. I'm more scared of junglers. Junglers are really the way that mid lane wins tremendously. I'm scared of teams to have good jungler and solo mid synergy, because if a jungler ganks from good angles or dewards you mid, or just puts a lot of pressure on you mid, you're more apt to make mistakes, you're more apt to lose the lane to the other solo mid. And so, one-on-one, I'm never scared of the other player. Like, I've got, like, I don't think many people are. Like, most top solo mids are pretty comfortable in being able to play middle. It's just that when you add that variability of junglers is when it becomes kind of dangerous. So I'm really scared of teams with very strong jungler and mid synergy, and just very strong junglers who understand like what angle to gank from and what to do against certain mids.